Well, hello everyone and welcome to Countdown to Southwest. My name is Tim Fox. It is great to have you. Yeah, we've got a pretty good crowd here already. We're a little bit away from the service. It is so good to be with you again tonight. I hope you've enjoyed Flashpoint on Sunday night and last night, and Flashpoint will be back tomorrow night in this time slot, so you won't miss anything if you come back for that. All this week, we are highlighting different parts of the ministry at KCM. Now, it's only a six-day meeting, so we can't highlight everything, but today we have been highlighting Kenneth Copeland Bible College, and you've probably seen that today if you've been watching. So my first guest tonight is a recent graduate of Kenneth Copeland Bible College. Would you please welcome Gabe Poirot to the program? How are you, sir?
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
Good to be here.
Okay, so you came from Virginia, right?
Yes, I did.
Okay, so what brought you to KCBC?
Yeah, so I was looking for Bible colleges.
Yeah.
The Lord had called me into ministry. But I just knew in my heart, like normal seminaries or 4 years just weren't going to cut it. I needed the Word.
Yeah.
And I didn't just need the Word. I needed like the Word. You know what I mean? Not just a Bible school,
right.
A Bible school.
Yeah.
And so hearing about KCBC, growing up listening to Brother Copeland ever since I was a freshman in high school.
Right.
I knew that the spirit of faith would be so caught so easily here. And so I just knew right away, I was like, yeah, KCBC's it.
Was it what you expected or did it exceed your expectations?
It was definitely exceeded my expectations.
Yeah.
For sure.
In what way? I mean, I know you walk into something like that thinking it's going to go one way,
yeah.
But what did it do that you did not expect?
You know, what I loved about the school was the connection to the instructors that I had. These instructors didn't just come in, give a nice little 60-minute lesson, but they would stay with us after the lessons. They'd talk with us through things.
Yeah.
They'd answer so many questions.
Right.
And we would live day to day with our practical lives. It was like a spiritual just like training course every single day.
It's only a 2-year program, but what was it like to finally reach graduation day?
It felt really good.
Yeah.
Especially with COVID and everything that happened, you know, there were so many things that it looked like so many times we didn't know what the next step would exactly look like.
Yeah.
But that graduation stage, holding that diploma, it's just like you finished and the Lord is good.
Yeah, we got pictures of you there that we're showing. What was it like to wear that gown?
Oh, it was a little heavy. I don't know where the photos are. Also, when I was carrying the diploma, I didn't know how to hold it, so I like had to grab it with my mouth. It was a little awkward. But
the thing about Bible school, and there are lots of Bible schools, lots of great Bible schools all over this country, but when you go to Bible school, obviously your goal, the end goal, end game, is to be in ministry and to do some sort of ministry. And that looks different for everybody. And especially now in this day and age we live in, there's so many options and so many ways to do ministry. I want to read you Gabe's mission statement for his ministry, and then I want to show you a video after that that will kind of introduce what he's doing. Gabe's mission is to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ and bring joy to the next generation. That's his mission statement. I want to show you a video to kind of give you a glimpse of what he's doing right now, and then I want to talk about how big it is and the impact it's making. Watch this.
If we make this 3, we get to learn something about God today. Oh, guess we made it. Let me tell you. In the Bible, it says that as far as east is from the west, so has God forgiven you. And you might think this 3-pointer is far. And you may feel like you're far even further from God. He'll still accept you. He'll still bring you in. You still have a shot. In fact, you have 100% chance of God accepting you as long as you repent, as long as you give your life to Him. Jesus loves you.
All right, now, the first question I have is, how many times did you have to do that before you made that shot?
How many takes?
How many takes were there?
It's probably about 10 or 15.
So you were doing it until you made it, because if you don't make it, then the whole video is pretty much irrelevant. Okay, so you have taken to social media. That's your ministry platform that you're using. Talk about, did you know that when you were in Bible school, or was that something God revealed to you while you were there?
No, actually, I didn't. So even in high school, I wasn't a big social media guy. But while I was in Bible school, I found myself, when the pandemic hit, all by myself in my apartment with nothing to do. And I finally had no more excuses to God to, you know, not get into this.
Right.
And so He put in my heart, and He said, your friends are all on their phones. Get on there. And so I just started up social media, downloaded the apps, you know, knowing where people were watching, and just started making videos.
Yeah. And so now you're on TikTok. You're on what, Instagram?
Instagram, YouTube.
YouTube.
Yep.
Give us a sense of how many followers you have, just in general terms.
Yeah, the Lord is good. On TikTok, 1.7 million.
1.7 million followers.
Yeah.
Golly. Okay, that's amazing. Little old guy from Virginia.
I know.
Right. Okay, what about Instagram and YouTube?
Instagram's right under 50,000, and then YouTube's 160,000.
Okay, so what kind of reaction are you getting? What kind of response are you getting from people that are watching your ministry on those platforms.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. At first I thought it would reach just mostly Christians, and Christians are tuning in, but what ends up happening is there's so many people out there who would never come into church that are finding these videos on their For You page, randomly popping up. You know, we know there's no random thing.
That's right, that's right.
I just feel like God's like in the back room of these social media rooms, you know, just getting the gospel out there.
Yeah, right.
And, you know, cancel culture can try their best, but.
Well, and that's the other thing about cancel culture. And we live in that time where that's something that's going on in social media and in regular media. How have you overcome that, by the way?
Well, you know, Brother Copeland taught us to walk by the wisdom of the Lord, to ask him and believe to receive it. And so my heart is to constantly be in a place of humility, knowing that just because something worked in the past doesn't mean it'll work in the future. And you have to day by day, Lord, what works for today?
You are reaching, in some ways, the unreachable with your ministry. I want to read a testimony that Gabe received just recently. And we'll put it up, and we've blurred out part of it because it's got a little bit of language. But you have to understand that some people, especially when they first get saved, they're still a little rough around the edges.
Yes, they are.
So this guy says, "Yo, bro, yo, bro, want to say God bless your soul, man. Wouldn't be sitting here at home if it wasn't for your videos to make me love Jesus and be reborn. I went out yesterday and saw a guy I was beefing with and ready to whoop his meh. But I thought about it. Jesus wouldn't want me fighting. So thanks to Jesus and your videos, take care." How does that make you feel, my friend? I mean, that's got to be really rewarding.
It does, and it's so real. You know, a testimony like that isn't manicured for the appearance of it. It's just like, look at my life. God changed my life.
Right. How do you come up with the ideas for the videos you do? I love the basketball one we show, but you do a lot of different things. How do you come up with that?
To be honest with you, sometimes I just have a thought and I'm like, let me go do this. And sometimes it works, sometimes it flops. You know what I mean? But I want to say it's the Lord, you know?
Right, right.
I believe it's the Lord.
Right, it is. What do you think the future holds? I mean, obviously there's a huge ceiling for what you're doing. And